The following is a production of the University of Minnesota.
There are several wild roses that flower in late spring and early summer. Three are recommended for Andrenid mining bees in Minnesota, those being Rosa Carolina, the pasture rose, Rosa Blanda, the smooth wild rose, and Rosa palustris, the swamp rose. They all range in height from 3 to 6 feet and all propagate by underground stems. All do better in full sun, especially because this reduces the incidence of foliar diseases. The smooth wild rose is hardy to zone 3, whereas the pasture rose and swamp rose are hardy to zone 4. The swamp rose, as the name suggests, is adapted to wet soils. The pasture rose prefers medium to wet soils, and the smooth wild rose prefers medium to dry soils. The pasture rose flowers in May, whereas the smooth wild rose and swamp rose flower in June. Roses lack nectaries, and as such, these can only offer pollen to Andrenid mining bees. Allium sclerophyllum, or chives, is a small bulbous perennial whose close relatives include garlic, shallots, leeks, and scallions. It's hardy to zone 4, reaches a height of 1 to 1.5 feet, blooms in May and June, and the globular flower clusters sit on stems that rise above the foliage. It thrives in rich organic matter, well-drained soil, in full sun, is tolerant of deer and some drought, and it tends to self-seed in the garden. Clovers are a major source of nectar and have pollen with a good quantity of crude protein containing all essential amino acids. Trifolium repens, or white clover, is a dwarf, mat-forming herbaceous perennial which typically grows to 4 inches tall and spreads to a foot or more. It is hardy to zone 3 and can be seen blooming throughout the season and has some tolerance to part shade. In contrast, red clover, or Trifolium pratense, is a taller plant growing from 6 to 36 inches, and its flower corolla is longer than white clover, restricting access to the nectaries to bees with longer tongues. Our next plant is Zizia aurea, Golden Alexander. It is an herbaceous perennial, hardy to zone 3, and reaches a height of around 3 feet, and its bloom time is between May and June. This plant grows in an average, medium moisture, well-drained soils, and does well in full sun to part shade. The flat-top clusters of yellow flowers are attractive to many kinds of insects seeking pollen and nectar, especially short-tongued bees. Physocarpus opulifolius, or ninebark, is a deciduous shrub hardy to zone 2 and reaching a height of 5 to 8 feet and a spread of 4 to 6 feet. It blooms in the May to June window and tolerates full sun to part shade. It prefers a dry to medium type soil but tolerates a wide range of soil conditions. Ninebark is easy to cultivate. It produces pink or white flowers. Flowers provide nectar and pollen to mining bees as well as a wide range of other insect visitors. We have two dogwoods to consider in this list, the gray dogwood, Cornus racemosa, and the red twig dogwood, Cornus sericea. Both are deciduous shrubs, hardy to zone 3, usually reaching a height of 6 feet. They both bloom in the May to June time window, although the red twig dogwood can have several flower flushes later in the season. They're both tolerant of a wide range of soil conditions. The gray dogwood tends to be more tolerant of drier soils, and the red twig dogwood more tolerant of boggy, wet soils. Both provide nectar and pollen. to mining bees as well as other insects. These two species can be distinguished by the number of veins they have on one side of the leaf. All dogwoods have arcuate veins, these arching veins, and the red twig dogwood has 5 to 6 of these arcing veins on one side of a leaf, whereas the gray dogwood has 3 to 4.
Thank you.